it's groundbreaking research. Partnering scientists with government, I think, opens up new opportunities and new insights.
It's very exciting to see that we're actually having an impact on people because of the technology.
It's heralding a new way of working for the department.
Harnessing the power of science to improve service delivery to millions of Australians. That's the aim of a $16 million five-year research alliance between the Department of Human Services and CSIRO.
What's exciting about it is a licence to explore rather than just our traditional role of delivering predetermined policies and programs.
When you're doing something complicated like human services, there are lots of opinions about what will work and what won't work, what's better and what's worse. What CSIRO brings as a science organisation to the Alliance is the collection of what we call robust evidence. So rather than having an opinion, we go out and we make some measurements, we do an analysis, and we say, well, from the information we've collected, we think this approach will be better than that approach.
We are actively, through this alliance, looking at gaining insights from the community, from citizens in the community, about how they want to deal with us and what they would like to do when they do deal with us.
The alliance is already producing results. Visi is a tool to monitor what customers are saying about the department in social media.
It then essentially adds some smarts to the process, trying to understand what are people talking about, grouping them into clusters, organising them into the appropriate discussion so everything gets grouped together, to then make it easier for somebody to look at what is happening up there on social media.
We find issues that we were never aware of before. We're more efficient as a result because the tool that we built together allows us to respond more quickly and archive those responses.
The pilot for Visi has proved so successful, it's been adopted by other agencies. And for the department's customers, it means they get the right information when they need it.
People have said that they're really surprised that the government would respond to their question, that they felt reassured that they received official government information in online forums, where often it's just people's opinions or experiences that are being shared. And we've also received votes for best answer on Yahoo Answers, and there's a bit of competition in our team to get best answer. And what we try to do is just take complex information and respond to people in a meaningful way so that they don't assess themselves out of support that they could be entitled to.
The Alliance is also helping customers through a special online community, Next Step, for parents required to move from one Centrelink payment to another.
The community is a tailored space that's been made just for them. So we did focus group testing before we created the community with parents, and we asked them what they would need from us. And a lot of the parents said that they don't get enough information from government when they need to do this transition.
We're looking at how do online communities work? How do people get involved in it? How can we design mechanisms to encourage people to interact in it, to share their experience, to support each other, to be active in the community so that the community has more of a life?
I think the benefit to the department is that we're helping customers get better outcomes for themselves. So by putting that bit of extra effort in early to give them the information they need, they can then make the right decisions for themselves. I think that makes them then less reliant on our department on the long term.
CSIRO is also measuring how trusting these customers are. Unique research with far-reaching implications.
The hypothesis is that the more trust people put in that community among each other and to a community provider, the more benefit they will get out of it, because the more they will share, the more they will interact. So we are essentially in the science looking at mechanisms to raise that social trust and ways to start measuring it. And that is also, I think, quite important because it might also increase the trust that the citizen might have with respect to government services and how the government is trying to support them.
There are about 25 CSIRO scientists working on projects as diverse as identifying the pathways people take through different social security services and methods to detect patterns in social worker demand. Other alliance projects are providing an evidence-based understanding of investment decisions and business processes.
The alliance provides us with a great opportunity to gain access to some really first-rate thinking that's going on in CSIRO.
It has given the department a five-year period in which to really focus on research to support our customers and to find efficiencies in the way that we do things.
We're measuring things that have never been done before in government.
The Alliance has the potential to have very big effects on the way human services are delivered in Australia.